But
hey, Robbie.
Good to see
you. Oh, you did what?
I just found it.
Oh, okay. Mine's you'll see all the dents on mine. All the
thank you.
You need to come up half a step to be flat.
Okay. Before we get started in rehearsal, I have a couple announcements. If I do not have your cell phone and email information on this piece of paper, see me after rehearsal, we'll get you down. Everyone, please remember we're taking some photos in a couple weeks. We still have to work out the timing, but we do need to pay the photographer. This is a photo shoot that would normally cost us $1,000 if we did it professionally, but I have a friend of mine who's still a student who does a fantastic job. She's done photos for me before. However, we need to get around $200. We can do a Kickstarter if necessary, but we have a large enough email address, our email list, that if everybody were to give $5, we'd have $200 easy. So if we can get that, we need to take care of getting ourselves some officers at some point. Right now we don't have the full section here, so we won't really discuss that because we don't know who all will be available. But I will try to send out some things out in the email this coming week about officers and what they'll do. Things like taking care of the collection of the $5 for the photographer will fall to the treasurer, and just some general decision-making things that will help me figure out exactly what everybody in the group wants to do, because I can't always speak to everyone every time. I've had a few people having issues with parts missing or folders missing, and I want to stress that it is very important that we keep up with our folders and our music, because I don't keep extra parts, first off, and many of these parts are not copies. Some of these are on loan from Hendricks College, and very many of them are originals. On top of that, if we get to rehearsal and we don't have all of the music, then we have people who are just sitting there instead of practicing this, and we lose a part in the ears of the rest of the players, and you lose rehearsal time for yourself if you don't have your part. Now, with all that out of the way, let's start with La Habanera. Bizet. We have a standard thing where we have really great section representation every other week.
Boom, boom.
B and go in. We're doing with the big, the chorus parts. What happens in the opera is you have Carmen singing while she's dancing around the police chief man, and then you have the chorus behind her that chants in at these big sections. They call after what she just sang back to her, and that's what your part is at C and at D. Let's see. And there at the end, I want to remind everyone, second to last measure, that I am breaking that down in order to really conduct the retard there, going into the fermata. There's the da 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 breath. It's a breath. And everybody comes in. The next measure. Down. Alright, so look, we're back at, what did I say? I said B. This is where the trumpet solo normally takes over. First violin is playing the same part, so that's what you'll hear now.
Two.
So we're going to that same spot for the end. Great, well, welcome.
I love you, Mitten.
Robbie, you have horn one, is that true?
That's correct, sir.
And the horn one folder has, what are the parts all labeled horn one?
Yes, sir.
Second to last measure. We're not Alright, did you see what I did that time? I was faster here. We weren't, we got there, but it took a second. That was because it was the first time we did something different. Let's try again. Do for La Habanera. I'm gonna move. What did I say was next? It was.
two.
Done a lot of waltz one before and the introduction. We're gonna skip past those. And remember last time we were waltz five and coda two running into one. This is the waltz. This is, I believe, the first waltz to start with a pickup. Yes, waltz two. It's not the second. It's not the second chunk. It should be the third chunk because the first chunk is an introduction, followed by waltz one.
Yeah. I'm seeing he stops his screen.
Waltz 2, let's review the roadmap. You've got the first section, which is repeated. So you'll go through the first section, take the first ending, go back to the beginning. When you get to it this time, take the second ending. You'll hop across the Schluss ending to the key change, which you'll play until the DS sign at the end of Waltz 2. Hit the DS sign and take one.
At the beginning, there's a, and like the fourth measure, do you want me to play that horn two cue?
The fourth measure, before you have a horn what now?
Two.
Oh, I thought you were talking about the top five. That's my fault.
Okay. So the roadmap, you play the first section, first ending, second ending, then you're gonna play the second section. You hit the DS, which takes you to the top of the piece, the top of Waltz two, not a cue thing. You'll play through, take the Schluss ending and stop. So you only play the second section of this waltz once. It's A, A, B, A, done.
Me
last beat before the beat.
Third.
You have a beat?
Well, you call it section AABA.
Oh, yes.
So the last beat before we start beat.
Correct.
Okay.
It's before the key change.
Right.
The beat. So I'll give you your standard prep, one, two, and then on the, we're doing this, I'm giving you a compound meter instead of one, two, three, one, two, three. So on the three of the breath measure is when you'll come in there. So I'm going to demonstrate that this thing because you'll have one, three, bum, bum. Thank you. it's coming across right now, it makes the first beat a little ambiguous because it comes out whoa, whoa. I want sort of a bomb, bomb. So that we know exactly where the start of the downbeat is. Try it with just the motor this time.
Okay.
especially the section where you have the rising quarter notes followed by the descending quarter notes. Right, that's that crescendo and decrescendo. Bring those out for us.
Is that 121?
Mm-hmm. I suppose for the first clarinet, they're not rising in the first measure. Okay. The main thing to pay attention to this time is that you are, we don't want any one part to overpower. We worked on getting the motor right. We need to be able to hear the motor the whole time. The melody is the part everybody actually hears, so we want to hear that the whole time. But we also don't want to say cover up the clarinets when they have their new section. We want everything in its place. Back at the B section for the pickup. One. Sections and end. I guess in the last section, you'll play the Swiss ending, that third one tacked onto the end, because it doesn't have a second beat. So let's read through this one. This may be easier. Let's count from the DS and count every measure that's on the paper. Counting the measure before the DS as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 measures back. And that's counting every measure on the paper. Regardless if you would play them after one another or not.
Measures after the line.
Yep.
There's a big old drum shot right there.
Okay. Okay.
Thank you.
this one we have this crescendo up to fermata, or up to forte. And it has the ending afterward. The ba da bum ba da 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 da.
Four from the end is actually marked F.
Four at the end.
I am talking.
Three from the end.
I am talking measure 159.
Yeah, three from the end.
Which cellos should have C, E, A, followed by a D on. No. Two measures before you have arco marked.
Half four before, is that what you're talking about?
My crescendo is marked one before, but you said you have a crescendo that's 4 measures long.
Well, no, I'm just looking at from the end, 1, 2, 3 is where the fortissimo is. Is the crescendo in that bar before that?
Yes, 1 measure before the forte.
Thank you.
So we have bassoons, cellos doing the rising quarter notes, we have the French horns doing what French horns do in waltzes. And we have a whole bunch of eighth note stuff going on in the woodwinds. And we want all that. Every other time, the woodwinds especially, they do the it's a little bit, it's right here in your pocket. This time, it's I don't know, it's really wanting to get out and go somewhere. And it's supposed to be a thing that'll trick you when you come to the end and you're going to repeat because you're... So we want to really swell it quite a bit so that we throw people off by switching back to quiet. I've talked about for the new ones, this waltz, a lot of this waltz is about making the dancers uncomfortable. So we're going to start at the place we started before with everybody, the 9 measures before the DS. Okay, much better. We need, I think most of our crescendo, well, I don't think, our most of our crescendo needs to come from the low end, definitely. We talked about last week, who leads a day crescendo?
Highs.
The highs lead the day crescendo because theirs is the part that's going to pierce through the sound the best, so they need to be the quietest in order for the balance to stay right. And the low end leads a crescendo because they're the wide bass. And if these guys, think of a pyramid with the bass on the bottom. If you have everything big and in balance, it's a great big pyramid, and the top end of the pyramid, the high winds, shrink down even smaller, the pyramid will be fine. It'll just look fine. If you have a tiny pyramid and the highs swell up really huge, then you have a top-heavy pyramid that will likely fall over. You guys keep us from falling over. So we need lots of you there. Same place again. One. Thank you.
Thank you.
So this is break time. Come back. I'll give you till 4:12. That's 5 minutes.
That's Mr. Matthews kind of thing. He does exact time.
Thank you for eyes up on that. We will work on doing it with a retard in the closure instead of just stop heading.
On the balance.